Hello, my name is Hugh Elms. I've lived in Wareham all of my life, and today I'm on a quest. My quest is to track down a Thomas Edward Lawrence. You may remember him as being Lawrence of Arabia. The latter part of his life, he spent a lot of time in Wareham. He lived in Bovington. Unfortunately, in 1935, he was involved in an accident, and unfortunately, he passed away. I was looking at a newspaper, and I saw that on the year 2005, it was the 70th anniversary of the death of Lawrence of Arabia. I'll be honest, I don't know a great deal about him, and I just can't understand why he had that name, and why he happened to live in that little cottage at Clouds Hill. You know, it's rather funny when we look around here, it's the most beautiful spot, is Clouds Hill. This is a home which I think he had for about 10 or 12 years. In all those times, there was never a lavatory built here. Clouds Hill provided a relief from camp life and a quiet place for him to write his great work, The Seven Pillars of Wisdom. Lawrence's exploits in the desert won him respect and admiration among the great and the good, many of whom travelled to Dorset to mourn his passing. Well, here we are at the cemetery at Morton. This is where poor old Lawrence came to rest after the fatal accident. Seems funny a place like Morton in the centre of Dorset where his body should be left. Now this morning I've got to go and look at some motorcycles as written by Lawrence of Arabia. And these are Brough motorbikes, and these are designed by George Brough.
If it is true and Lawrence was assassinated, who would have benefited from his removal?
I must say it was a road traffic accident. Whether or not there was something else behind that accident is the question mark. The trouble with identifying those people is that they are legion.
What do you think about these conspiracy theories?
Well, I think they're a lot of nonsense.
I don't think anyone can know Lawrence. That's what's so wonderful about him. He's such a broad personality, a sort of Renaissance man. He sort of does everything, and the whole Lawrence story is so compelling. He's so wonderfully flawed. That's what makes him so interesting. And the fact he's compellingly enigmatic, and you never really knew quite what Lawrence was doing. He always gave two stories or three stories, one to his family, one to the press, one to the public, probably one to the politicians, just innumerable stories. That is Lawrence. He faced all directions at once.
I shall never forget it as long as I live.
This hour-long DVD is obtainable from the museum shop. I hope you have a lot of pleasure watching it.